I don't know why I was immediately drawn to nature as opposed to robots when I was little. Everything that was interesting to me used nature at some level as the building blocks, whether it was in biology, how carbon atoms bonded with hydrogen, or how walls in Japan have the same sort of lattice form of those chemical bonds, is this sort of cohesive visual language that is all around me, and I have no choice but to kind of internalize it and highlight it and try to capture it in my work. My earliest memory would be sketching with my mom. She had this pretty common game that we played called the doodle game that I loved, where she would start with this sort of amorphous form and then I would have to turn it into something recognizable. And then both my parents were adamant that I choose a career that was fun. And to me, that symbolized fun. And so I kept sketchbooks throughout my childhood. It was always a relaxing, kind of cathartic exercise. I didn't even know when I went to art school that I wanted to do three-dimensional things. I thought I was going to do illustration. As soon as I realized that my two-dimensional drawings could easily become objects and functional objects that people could interact with, then there was no looking back. I had to bring the objects, the drawings, into our world. I did a sketch for this one client. It's a drawing of these lattice patterns and clovers and Japanese stars, and they're sort of morphing into each other and intersecting, and then branches are weaving in and out. At Miami, we're doing these really big doors. Evan and Zesty from R20th saw the drawing and asked me if I could sort of magnify it and really create this sort of ultimate experience of these intersecting patterns. It is something I have to do. Maybe it's born from my dissatisfaction with the disposable culture that we come from, and that I just want to see more thought and more beauty in our objects and environments. When you make something from scratch, it's this amazing, empowering feeling that you can really be totally self-sufficient using these age-old techniques that really haven't changed since the ancient Egyptians. We're like really engaging with the materials of an object. And when you do that, feel like you learn so much more about what the material wants to do. I could never have just designed my objects on paper. I had to sort of see how the grinder created these facets on the bronze. And so the work is about kind of being present with the material, listening to it, and asking what it wants to become.